A team of orthopedic specialists from the United States flew into the country to specifically handle some of the complex cases at the orthopedic medical camp in honor of King Oyo's 31st birthday. The cases included bone deformities, joints, ligaments, tendons, muscles, and nerve damage.
To enable the less fortunate subjects in his kingdom access life-changing surgery and treatments that they would otherwise not afford. Many of our people cannot afford that. This year, mainly children with deformed limbs, club foot, and the rest are being operated upon.
There's nothing as good as touching the health of the population or the people the king rules over, and more so the children. I believe he also has a heart for children. I believe if you correct a young child who could not walk and he walks, you improve the future of that child and the future of the nation.
There are quite many health challenges affecting our community, and the resources are scarce. You have brought for us these specialists to bridge this gap. Please do come again.
Toro Queen Mother Bess Kemigisa, while closing the medical camp, thanked the team of surgeons for responding to the king's call to offer health services to the needy.
Breaking bones and then put them together, here it can cost a lot of money, millions of money. But you came here, you bought your own ticket, you came with medicine. We really thank you so much. On behalf of the kingdom, we really have done much. You've been there for
12 years. So this project started by the vision of the king. The king have a heart for his people. He wants to make sure the children, the elderly, the adults, that nobody left behind, that he want to create a strong kingdom and health system.
I am so grateful to the kingdom because I did not even imagine that my child would one day walk, because I did not have the money to carry out such an operation. I had been referred to Kilembe Hospital in Kasese, where I was asked to pay 1.5 million shillings, but I did not have the money. I am so grateful to the king and the kingdom because my son has now been treated for free. Story by Roger Sandy for the news.